You are now at WordPress backend with the Elementor Pro Site Builder. Today, we will talk about how to use the Products Archive tab within the Theme Builder for Elementor Pro. So this Products Archive is for us to design our products category pages. When we add products on WooCommerce, the category pages will automatically get created. And how do we view them? Like for this bathing category, you may actually click on view to view how your category page will turn out. And usually they do have a very standard template that is a limit to how much we can change how we want our category page to look. So this sample will show you how the original category page will turn out, the ones that is provided by WooCommerce. Please note that it's just add to cart because the quick add to cart as well as the compare buttons are additional plugins that we use. So it's just your add to cart, price with the title and then the product listing. The sample is the category title and this just a sample page is the category description. That's all. So usually, if we are just working with WooCommerce, the only place where we can add a little bit more customization will be appearance and then customize. So if we go to WooCommerce here and product catalog, we may decide on what we want to display for our category display. So you can decide whether you want to show products or show subcategories or show both subcategories and products. I usually decide to show products, all right, because it can be a little bit messy when we show both because they don't segregate the two sections for us. In fact, they're just listing our subcategories here. Maybe if we have two subcategories and then the next one, they'll just follow on with the product listing. So we usually just use show products here. Now, default product sorting. We don't adjust this much because there is already a default sorting of filter box here for our audience to sort. So we may actually ignore this part. Now, products per row, this will be another element and an aspect that we can adjust. So let's say if we change it to 6 products per row, it will look like this, okay? And then rows per page, if I change it to 1 row per page, then it will include the pagination for me as well. And it's just going to present 1 row per page. All right, so let's just stick with this setting and then we click on publish. Okay, and then we close this out and we go back to the theme builder. Okay. So now we are going to do a little bit more design for our sample category. And let's just see how it turns out, okay? So I'm just going to name this template sample. Okay, so what we have from WooCommerce, we'll bring it in to our Elementor editor. I'll cross this out. Okay, so for Elementor, we don't have to stick to this ugly looking header category title here or just a simple description here. We don't have to stick to this layout, all right? We may really design our own layout. So we have this product archive elements here, 3 of them. These are the query elements. So when we use archive title, it'll query out the category title automatically. We'll query out also the products for that particular category automatically. And you'll also query out the category description. So say I'm going to create a new session and put it as full width. And then I will drag this archive title here. Okay, so this would be the category title. So you may just ignore these words over here. They will not appear at the front end. Your category title will appear at the front end, right? So let me just do some settings over here and go to the session. I'll go to style. and add a color for the background and have a little bit of a hover effect over here. Okay. And then I may want to add a little bit of a padding as well over here. Okay, so I also have a archive description. So I'm going to add another section. Okay, that is full width as well. Stretch it. Okay, and then I shall pull over my description here. So I'll centralize my description. Okay, maybe add some margin. Okay, add some margin. Okay, so we will only be able to see the our design effects when we live this and we see it from the front. We won't be able to see it here. Okay, so we don't do that much over here for description. Now let's just pull over my archive products. Okay, I'll pull it over here. It's a new session. I'll click on this edit session. I will do a full width. Okay. I'll just hit to full width and I will stretch it. So this will be six products in a row, the way we set it in earlier under appearance and customize. You may ignore these two rows because we did set it to one row. So at the front end, it'll just appear as one row. All right. So let's maybe do something. Let's style it a little bit. Okay, say we click on this, make sure it's edit archive products. We click on style. Okay, so from here, we may style quite a bit of things. We may decide on columns gap, rows gap, alignment, the image, whether we want some border. So say I want a solid border. Okay, and then there is actually an automatic hover effect on the border. So say if I want to just increase the width a little bit, make it more obvious. Okay, perhaps I may want alignment to be centralized for all, and then you see it's all centralized. Title color, you can change that. We don't have ratings yet, so we can't really assign the rating design. You can actually also do a change in your button colors, okay, as well as this card, add to cart, okay, or view cart. Now look at this box here. This box will be the box that contains the entire product details. Okay, so it's different from the image border. This is a whole box border. So let's just try, if I were to increase the border width, it's going to look like this. But too many lines make it a little bit heavy. Okay, so we may want to do a box shadow. Okay, or we may want something without shadow. And then when you hover, then there is a shadow. Okay, so when you hover, there is a shadow. Okay, so but this shadow may be too small, I mean too squeezy. Okay, it's a little bit too squeezy in the box, so I may want to increase the padding here. Okay, I may want to increase the padding, and so if you shadow over, you'll see a little bit more space between the box and the product, the elements inside. Okay, so let's just increase a little bit more. Yeah, so here it is. So when you hover, there is a shadow. Okay, yeah. So you can't really achieve this effect by WooCommerce default template alone. So that's why you use the theme builder to achieve the right design style that you want. All right. So other than doing the style editing over here, we may add whatever else we want into the product category page. So for example, if I want to add one more section, full width and stretch, okay, I may add maybe a header over here. Okay, I may add a header, and this header says call us to customize. All right, okay, and then I centralize this thing, style it perhaps a little bit bigger. Okay, so that every single category page that I assign this layout to will definitely have these words call us to customize. Okay, now let's try to publish it. Add condition. I do not want to add to every other page. I only want to add this to my sample category. Okay, and then I save and close. It's already updated. Let me go to my sample page. It was like this. Let me refresh. And then now it's like this. Okay, so it makes our product category pages highly customizable. If you would like to have different look and feel for different parent categories, for example, you may also design the different templates, the different layouts, and then use the condition page to assign them to the right categories. Okay, so you may actually play around with the design a lot more if you use the Elementor Pro Theme Builder for product category. So I hope this is clear. So that is all that I would like to show for this video. Thank you for watching.